A month ago, I made a video showcasing Monster Hunter Tri-G and the Classic Controller Pro, using them together and such. When I first made it, I had no experience with this thing. Just wrapped it out of the box and such, unwrapped it. But now it's been a month, and I'd like to showcase my opinion on this accessory. But before that, I'd like to show off some gameplay footage of me playing without, well, playing this game without this and with it. First up, I'd like to showcase an underwater battle without the add-on circle pad. So, for underwater, you can control with the virtual D-pad or the actual D-pad. It's just like as it was in Tri. If you're using the classic controller, that is. I have no idea what the controls were for the Wii Remote and Nunchuck. I never touched it. So this is a Hunt a Laggy quest. High rank village quest, actually. I'd also like to test my luck and try to get myself a couple of those damn horn pluses or whatever they are supposed to be. So yeah, underwater movement without the Classic Controller Pro is pretty much the same as it was in Tri. You can move left and right, up and down. Also moves the camera. Sometimes it makes for awkward camera angles, especially when diving into the water, because at first it's when you first dive into the water, you can't see a damn thing, because the surface of the water is colored dark blue, and you really can't see anything out of the dark blue. The game's frame rate also drops whenever it tries to render that dark blue. Once you get into the water, it's fine, but like areas like Area 9 in Deserted Island have a few frame rate issues if you're facing the water. Okay, now. Yeah, so I'm using the Gun Lance right now. My personal favorite weapon. Oh my god. Chacha just activated one of the skills I equipped on him, which was Place Shock Trap skill. I don't know why I even have it on him. He barely does it. What am I doing? Get it? Oh god, what am I doing? I should be attacking the face. Anyway, for underwater, as well as with land battles, I use the combination of the virtual D-pad, the actual D-pad, and the target camera, which is the thing where it's right here on the touchscreen. If you press it once, it does this, do like that, regular center camera. I'm sure you've heard about it when the game was first revealed, back in whatever, what was it, some sort of Capcom conference, I think. Anyway, you can make this virtual D-pad bigger, move it around the screen, bottom screen. You can pretty much customize it to your will. So if you have like super large fat hands, you can make the D-pad as wide as the little box that's right here, so it can accommodate your fatty fingers. And there's even a three square size, rectangle size one, so it reaches up from here to here. Even with the Circle Pad Pro, I use the target camera. It's very convenient. I'm sure it's returning in Monster Hunter 4, but I know it doesn't have underwater battles, Monster Hunter 4, but sometimes during underwater battles, the camera, target camera decides to like get super lazy and doesn't want to work, sometimes it goes halfway, like while it's maybe got lost while it's searching for the monster or something. But sometimes it doesn't go reach all the way to the monster, and just decides to center the camera on some piece of like just some random ocean. Did it break? Or was that a bubble? Now it's broken. Oh, I thought I made it. I'm not that pro anymore. What a shame. Alright, time to cut the tail. If I can actually hit it. I'd rather have the laggy not fall over and babble around like a baby. I'd rather have it do that. Yeah, that's good. Shit. Hopefully I'll get to show off the target camera retardation on camera today. Oh, that's what I get for not paying attention. Also, I really lack... Oh, see? See? It did it. Maybe it's because it's underwater and the camera has to focus on, like 18 cardinal directions or whatever the hell. But it sometimes it decides to not work. I mean, it's not a problem. Well, yeah, actually, it is a problem. It could cause you to lose some zenny. Which is not good. Oh shit. Oh, you can barely see the laggy on camera. Yeah, this is the Rathalos Gunlance. Its highest sharpness is blue so far, because it's the highest, it's the best route. It's that high as the. It needs G rank parts to upgrade, and I don't have G rank yet. I'm moving slowly but surely through the game, even though it's been almost a year since it's been out in Japan. Oh, I can show off the frame rate drop. Yeah, I don't have the light. I think someone said that having the lights off made the screen better to see, but I want to show off how my hands work. Partly because I'm curious myself. So yeah, no pretty picture quality. Yeah, it's not really noticeable on camera, but it is noticeable in real life. So prepare yourself and don't whine too much. Although when this game goes in 60 frames per second, whenever there's like one monster on the screen in the area you're in, doesn't have too much stuff going on, it looks pretty amazing. Also, dynamic shadows are quite beautiful. The mask that Kayamba's wearing, Kayamba's the new shakalaka that you get in the story. There's no story. But there is Kayamba. And he's wearing the excellent mask. Makes him invincible. But it kills his HP. Chacha's wearing a Rathalos mask. It lets him spit out fireballs. And all his speech turns to roar. sounds so somewhat entertaining right there, and it's already limping. Oh fuck. Another tail? I want a gem. When I showcase this underwater battle again, I will not show all of it, so it will not be this long. Hell, maybe I'll even cut out the parts where I'm loading the screens and stuff. Loading times aren't that bad, so maybe not. Speaking of loading times, that Kirby's Adventure 3D Classic takes a shit as... Oh god, loading times are pretty awful. Especially when it decides to save every damn... after every level you clear. That didn't happen in the NES version, nor the GBA version. So, I don't know what the... Maybe the 3D is so... so breathtaking that it needs to load and shit. There we go. At first, playing underwater battle is kind of hard to get used to, but if you keep at it, you'll get used to it. Like anything, pretty much. Even in Try, when you first, I'm pretty sure when everyone when they tried out the underwater battles in Try, I'm sure they were confused and like, what the fuck is going on, but you'll get used to it. And now I'll be showing off a land battle without the Classic Controller Pro. Classic Cup of... When you're playing without the accessory, well, when I'm playing without the accessory, I usually have my pinky finger right here to better, even when I'm playing like this, I have it right here to, like, get a better grip on everything. But unfortunately for me, these damn LEDs have, you know, I'm sure you know, but they're, like, little bumpy things. So it kind of hurts, but you live with it. Or you can always shave it off. Whichever one appeals to your wallet. This time I'll be using a sword and shield. The Baryoth sword and shield. With an armor set that has fire element plus one. So, one of the skills is completely useless. The other skills on this are attack up large and speed sharpen. Attack up large was gemmed in originally. If you just equipped regular Rathalos high rank armor, you get attack up medium. And there is Jinoga. I think it's weak to ice, pretty sure. I've only fought this thing like three times, so I'm not too sure what's going on and stuff, so you'll have to excuse me if I make any fuck-ups. I do know that it has a tail, and the tail needs to be cut. I like the music. I skipped over Portable 3rd, so instead of playing Portable 3rd, I just played Portable 2nd G, Freedom Unite, since, after Try was my first Monster Hunter game. After Try, I decided to venture further into the series. So my second game was Freedom Unite. And then I downloaded Monster Hunter G for the Wii. I think it's gonna release its energy thing soon. There it is. Target camera works very well for, oh god, for a somewhat small but not too small. Well, it works well for all small monsters. I don't know if I said this or not, because I have like several failed attempts at it. Oh, what the hell? Failed cuts, shall we say. And in one of them, I think I mentioned how... Oh, shit. On the larger monsters, the camera, whenever you press L for target camera... Oh, God, I didn't even notice, I was stunned. Whenever you press L for target camera, the camera always centers in the middle of the monster. Like, you can't... Yeah. The red thing always goes in the middle. You can kind of see it right now. No matter where you are, it goes in the middle. Like, oh god. Yeah. And if the monster is very huge, like, just take Gen Morn for example, it doesn't help you, because the middle of Gen Morn is the middle of no one cares. You, if you're fighting Gen Morn, you're going to be either looking at its, like the top backish area, or actually all around the boat, not just the middle. But to give a more practical example, say like the a large laggy. Sometimes the camera will go to the middle, yeah, but the monster is pretty large, so getting the thing in the middle is pretty it will be a negative instead of a positive. You'll be able to see what's going around. Is it gonna release this energy? Yes, and I got hit. There's the damn Curl Pecco dancing around. And oh god. And oh god. What's happening? So I hear Capcom localized the Jinoga's name as Xenogre? I'm not really sure how to pronounce that. And I keep forgetting he does that whenever he's enraged. Where'd it go? Oh god. I usually keep the 3D off on this game because it lowers the frame rate. And honestly, I don't think the 3D is very good. Nothing really, doesn't really do anything for me. I don't think it helps with, where's the damn thing? I don't think it helps with depth perception underwater or anything. So turn off the conserved battery, get rid of that annoying LED that pops up, and to enjoy that 60 frames per second whenever it happens. Oh god. Is it gonna eat? What's it doing? Moog, what the hell? It eats rocks? I don't even know what's going on anymore. Did I get... Oh god. Oh god. Yeah, this still happens. Can't do anything about it. You think Capcom would have enough money from all the DLC they put out as soon as the game is released to do some, like, testing and shit, but no. Yeah, this is Moga Woods. Not Deserted Island, this is Moga Woods. And Moga Woods Night becomes a party house of all the monsters, pretty much. It's like the, I don't know what you'd call it. It's like New York City. A whole bunch of people, not people, but like, different kinds of people gathering from all parts of the world into one single place. So you can even see like the Urugan and the Urugan subspecies, as well as this thing and Narukuga, the black thing with the cool music. I don't think you can see Agnictor though. Some of these names are quite tongue twisters. No, you can't see the bunny though. The Urukus, whatever it was called. At least I don't think you can. I don't remember. Oh, it didn't do the flip. What the fuck? Damn game. Anyway, I'll leave it off of here for this part. Not part, but this segment, so... yeah. And now it's time to show some Circle Pad Pro action. Go to options. Turn this to yes. Let it load. Oh shit, I forgot to put in the thing. Whoops. There we go. Okay, yeah, we're ready to go. As I said before, the Circle Pad Pro has these little bumpy things to make it easier to hold. You can see some of my sweat right there. So you can hold it pretty much just like a Wii U gamepad, I think. I've only felt the Wii U gamepad at a some store. I forgot what it was. Maybe a Walmart. But yeah. Let me just take care of this, restock on potions, and then I'll show off. Oh, what should I show off? I'll use the switch axe. The Brachydios switch axe. Now, with the Circle Pad Pro, we don't really need the original D-pad anymore since we have this thing. Yeah, the second analog stick Circle Pad can act as another D-pad, pretty much. Oh, wait, actually, it is another D-pad. So, pretty much everything that you can do with a D-pad, you can do with this. So, watch me flip through the items, or the menu options. It also works in the item box too. Yeah. So we don't need this virtual D-pad. So let's switch over to another touchscreen layout that I have. You can say up to three. I have one meant for without use for this thing, with use with this thing, and with use but for gunner things. But I don't really do. I actually don't have any. I didn't change it. Whoops. Oh fuck. I accidentally deleted it. That's a good time to showcase this then. You can drag and drop. Actually, I need this. And I usually have. What did I have? That's HP. It'll showcase the HP down here, but I don't like it because I like having it up here and it's, I don't know. It's a thing that I have. That's the player, player thing. Shows what other players are, what they're up to, pretty much. What did I have? That's my last thing. Oh yeah, the pinging. I think I had it like this. Let me just save it to my favorites. Set 2, yes, okay. Okay, we're ready. Alright. Now I will be showcasing a water battle and a land battle with using the controller pad pro. Ah, fuck. I'll just call it whatever I want to call it and whatever comes to mind. A good thing about this little show HP thing right here is that it showcases the quest objective and the amount of time you have left and blah blah blah. It's pretty, oh god. It's pretty good. No, my cat. Please stop rubbing your pheromones on my thing. This game also features gyro controls. Just kidding. Yeah, just a tap will get you out of that thing. And look, it has the logo for Monster Hunter Tri-G. Actually, that's just the logo for Tri. Oh, fuck. I thought I was supposed to fish it out. Oh my god. Yeah, that's the Plessy off. Okay. There we go. As we can see, you can still move with the D-pad. If I had the virtual D-pad, you could still move with that. I also have the target camera activated, as well as this thing. As you can see, it works just like a regular D-pad. And, oh yeah, in the previous video I mentioned about the ZR and ZL buttons. I find that, I never really touch ZL. I don't know why, but with the positioning of my hands like this, oh god. Like this, ZL is, for me, is hard to reach, so I just use L. And my hand looks like this while I'm running over there. Yeah, it looks like this when I play. I'm just gonna go in the water. Actually, I gotta... when I'm running around, I usually... just like I did in Tri. I'm pretty sure a lot of people also did this in Tri. Like this, you know. And I use the ZR button whenever I want to use any type of R action. The R button on the small R button doesn't really fit my tastes. So right now I'm using the Brachydios Switch X. The all-new explosion status effect. And I'm fighting the fan-favorite Blissey off. Oh, fuck, I forgot my thing wasn't there. Yeah, thank god the damn hitboxes are actually, not shit. You can break the fins and the wings, I guess you call it, as well as the head. I'm not sure you can cut off the tail. I don't think so. Let's break that head. If you can actually stop hitting it, or actually start hitting it. Hope it goes into the water so I can showcase water with the thing. Fighting this thing underwater is a lot easier than fighting it on land. Underwater, you know, you have a pretty much full 16,000 cardinal direction movement. You can easily break the fins and whatnot if you are underwater. And it won't do that stupid snake slither thing, and I fucking hate that move. It has such a big hitbox. Even in this game. It runs like a retard. I fucking hate this monster. Let me just recharge my switch axe. This option right here is the pinging for either Chacha or Kayamba. I'm not sure what happens if you play in multiplayer, because obviously you can't multiplayer if no one around you has the game. And Capcom really likes to prevent friendships forming across borders because there's no cross-region play. So I'm pretty sure Tri-G for the 3DS will not be able to play with Tri-Ultimate for the American NTSCU and PAL territories. So, no bonding over Monster Hunter at an airport where you find a Euro, a Japanese, and the Burger Muncher. There will be no friends formed. Actually, I think PAL versions and of Freedom Unite and NTSCU versions of the same game are compatible. Not sure though. Anyway, controlling underwater is a bit easier thanks to the Control Pad Pro. God damn it. Oh, there we go. Broke the thing. Fin. Wing. Instead of reaching down this way, you'll be reaching to the side. It's a bit more convenient, but it's not, I know I just said it was amazing and shit, but let me take that back. It's a bit more convenient, but it's not a deal breaker. God, what am I doing? Just going down on a touch screen, like, oh, fuck. Yeah, it's one of his new moves, pretty easy to avoid if you're not being retarded. Fortunately, I am being retarded. Going back up. Plus, he really loves land. Whenever I'm using this thing, I usually keep my fingers on, like, near the A button so I can quickly do this and stuff. Normally, I'd be, you saw the video footage, you should know. I wish I was taller. I could be hitting the head by now. And not getting hip checked. I'll just use axe mode and get hit. And oh no. Yeah, but playing Fighting Plessy is pretty fun. A lot more fun than it was in the previous games where you just sit around and wait until it actually says to come up on land. Ooh, and another gripe. Look at that water effect. You can't really see it well, but it looks like shit. It looked a lot better in Tri. I don't know how water looks like in Portable Third since I never played it. So, yeah. I think it looks better in the Flooded Forest, but I don't really go to the Flooded Forest that often. Well, let me rephrase that. I don't really repeat quests that have to make me go through the Flooded Forest. Either that or the monsters I fight in the Flooded Forest aren't really water type things. Because Flooded Forest underwater battle is like cramming yourself in a small room with 3,000 other people. I wish I had some depth perception. There we go. No, that we don't. What's it doing? Oh, it jumped out of the water. I guess I'll go break that fin wing. Oh, that was lucky. That was also lucky. Explode, come on. I want to break all of its parts. Sitting in this awkward position is making my leg fall asleep, and it hurts kinda. But enough about me, more about the game. We're playing Monster Hunter Tri-G, showcasing an underwater battle with the classic controller, with the accessory. What is that white thing? The shark. I think Kayamba took the killing bullet. Oh, that's Chacha. Whoops. Oh no, maybe it wasn't. Oh, forget it. Plus, the Yoth decides to float around before dying completely. It's kind of annoying. But then it dies like a rock in the previous games when you kill it. So, maybe it's doing its best to live. This is just a quick extra to show off the bow. The bow, in my opinion, suffers a lot from being on the 3DS. Not insulting the 3DS, but oh god. It just suffers. Unfortunately, I like the bow. I wish it wasn't so hard to control, in my opinion. It's hard to control. Now that's because whenever you hold R and whenever you move, the camera swings down like crazy, and it's very hard to both aim or like charge your shot, do this, and control the camera, and like for precise hits. Like, I mean, I hit the Great Jackie just because I was lucky, but like, yeah. In previous games, it didn't move around like this. The camera. I think there's a option to change it in the options menu, but I'm lazy so I haven't checked. And while you're charging your bow and moving around, because you don't want to get hit, you can't really do this or do this. So if you want to use the bow a lot, I'm guess you're just gonna have to like charge it, run to the monster, kind of like do this and hurry up and get away, I guess. I don't know. The Circle Pad Pro doesn't really help in this regard. Although, I know I've said this earlier, but I really do like the ZR button. Well, I'm pretty sure people have their own ways of dealing with the bow already. I just haven't made up my own or was curious enough to research it. Killed a cat. Anyway, that's all I have to say on the Circle Pad Pro. Yeah, I finally said it right. All in all, I do not think it's worth $20. Yeah, however, if you have fat hands, or if you're looking to try another control style, or if you really just hate using touchscreens, which is strange because almost everyone who's in has a smartphone with a touchscreen. But yeah, if you don't like the touchscreen controls, or if you just have fat hands and want to hold the 3DS in a more comfortable position, go for it. But if you're fine with the way it is and think that if the way the system is right now, and you can use the touchscreen style well enough to hunt and shit, don't think that using just because you have this thing, it'll make you a magical, skilled, legendary monster hunter. Because, in all honesty, if you're used to the touchpad controls, not touchpad, if you're used to the virtual D-pad, it'll work just as fine as a physical thing. So that's all I have for today. Goodbye.